It is time for our pet of the week, and our veterinarians here to answer some of your questions. We welcome back Dr. Paul Welch, Trails Animal Hospital, and he has Hobson the Catahoula with him today. So Catahoulas are the, I guess, Catahoula cow dogs is what they're known as?
Catahoula cow dogs. So it's kind of like a Australian Shepherd or Border Collie, that kind of personality. And they're busy.
He's a 2.5-year-old, totally very active. He would be a great running buddy for somebody, and he gets along well with other dogs. So if you would like to adopt Hobson, just really a handsome fella, you can call the Animal Rescue Foundation, 622-5962. You can visit their ARF house at La Fortune Park as well during the hours on your screen. You can also visit newson6.com/pets for other pets who need to be adopted. Speaking of running buddies, La Fortune, what a great place to start.
That would be.
Well, let's get started with our questions. The first one is about what is the earliest age a cat or dog can be neutered?
Okay, you can actually neuter the dogs as early as about 3 months old, and they'll do that at the Tulsa Animal Shelter, for example, just making sure that they don't have, you know, the problems with puppies and kittens. Now, normally we will neuter at about 6 months to a year. As far as that goes, Spain at about 6 months old. But again, it can be done what they call early neutering in Spain, usually at animal shelters and that sort of thing, as early as about, really as early as about 12 weeks.
So. Okay. This next one, my neuter dog is house trained, but just recently started having accidents almost daily, despite no change in routine or no change in food. How do I determine the reason for the behavior so we can end it? What other factors should I look for?
Okay, big thing we're thinking about, and it's kind of hard to tell right now, is it urination or stool? If it's stool in the house, then what I've got to think is there a reason the dog's not going outside, and we just need to make sure there's not something the dog is afraid of outside or nervous about, or just flat doesn't want to go out in this kind of cold weather. If it's urination, is it incontinence where he doesn't know that it's happening? And if that's the case, then we're asleep, we wake up and the puddle is there. Now, if he's hiking a leg or something like this, at that point, that's dominant behavior, and we've either got other smells or another dog in the house, or dogs outside, we're having to do things. And that's where we need to just explain to him that that is not tolerated in this house in no uncertain terms. If there's questions, talk to your veterinarian.
And now, as our cameraman has just gotten the first shot of his face, he's just so busy. He's just so busy. You're going to have to help me out with this one. Titer testing?
Titers. Yeah, okay. Testing with titers.
What is titer testing? How does it contribute to over-vaccination?
Okay, one of the things we used to think is that we were having problems with over-vaccinating dogs, and what they were doing is we were checking their vaccination status with titers, and that would just, what level is the distemper, rabies, and things like this. What we found is, first of all, we probably were over vaccinating. We're now giving, like, distemper and parvovirus can be given every 3 years. We know that rabies can be given every one or three years, depending on which vaccine you're using. And that's taken care of that over vaccination situation quite well. The other thing is, what the titers are, is it's to show if they've been vaccinated, but we're finding that the titers aren't the only thing that goes into that. So they're not sure that really titer testing accurately tells you the protection your dog has. And to be honest, I hate to say it, but it costs about $100 to test for a titer, and a fraction of that to vaccinate. So there's really no really good reasons to test titers anymore. So not something I would suggest.
Okay. Well, thank you so much.
Absolutely.
And again, this is Hobson, up for adoption, Animal Rescue Foundation of Tulsa. You can email us, noonshow@newson6.net, as always.